Welcome to Professor Grace's graphic class. Before you start this lesson, download the linked reference file and please watch the ad until the end so you can receive better content. In this tutorial, we'll take a look at the options and the features of the stroke panel. The cap option on the first artboard page is useful when you want to change the shape of the end of an unconnected path. If you select the first line, you will see the butt cap icon selected in the stroke panel. The strokes drawn in Illustrator use butt cap as the default, which is basically a straight shape of the beginning and end of the path. Select the second line and click the round cap icon in the stroke panel. You see rounded edges at the end of the starting and ending anchor points of the unconnected path by 10 points, which is half of the stroke thickness of 20 points. When you draw characters, the round cap allows you to draw soft and beautiful shapes on disconnected lines. Select the third line and click the projecting cap icon in the stroke panel. You see a projecting cap out of the starting and ending anchor points of the unconnected stroke by 10 points, which is half of the stroke thickness of 20 points. Press Shift-Ctrl-A to release the selection. You see that both ends of the line with the projecting cap and the line with the butt cap have the same shape. However, the difference between these two options is that the line using the projecting cap is longer at both ends by half the thickness of the stroke. Press spacebar and drag the mouse down to move to the second page. Press Ctrl-0 to fit the artboard to the window size. The corner option is useful when you want to change the shape of the corners of connected paths. If you select the first box, you see the miter join icon selected in the stroke panel. The shape of the corner of the connected path drawn in Illustrator basically uses miter join, which makes a sharp corner. Select the second box and click the round join icon in the stroke panel to make the corners of the connected lines round. Select the third box and click the bevel join icon in the stroke panel to make the corners of the connected lines beveled. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to release the selection. Press spacebar and drag the mouse down to move to the third page. Press Ctrl-0 to fit the artboard to the window size. The Align Stroke option is available when you want to change the position of a stroke applied to a normal path, not to editable text. If you select the first G, you will see the Align Stroke to Center icon selected in the stroke panel. The stroke applied to the object basically uses Align Stroke to Center as the default, which aligns half the thickness of the applied stroke inside of the path and the other half outside. If you select the second G and click the Align Stroke to Inside icon in the stroke panel, you will see that the actual object's area is reduced by aligning the stroke inside the path. If you select the third G and click the Align Stroke to Outside icon in the stroke panel, you will see the area of the path completely by aligning the lines outside the path. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to release the selection. Press the spacebar and drag the mouse down to move to the fourth artboard page. Press Ctrl-0 to fit the artboard to the window size. Dashed line is useful when you want to change the solid line to a dashed line. An arrowhead is useful when you want to add arrowheads to both ends or one side of an unconnected line. After selecting the first line, check dashed line in the stroke panel. You see that the first dash has the default value of 12 point and the remaining gap and dash have no input values. If you type input values for the first dash but do not type and the remaining gap and dash like this, the input value typed in the first dash is applied to the remaining gap and dash. After selecting the second line, check dashed line in the stroke panel. By clicking on the first dash and gap fields respectively or pressing tab, type 12 point, 8 point, 10 point, 6 point, 8 point, 10 point in order. Thus, you can create a more natural dashed line by typing different input values for dash and gap. If you uncheck dashed line while the dashed line is selected, you will return it to solid line. This time, I will show you how to add arrowheads to both ends of an open path. Select the third line, click the left arrowheads drop-down button in the stroke panel, and select arrow 37. Click the arrowheads drop-down button on the right, then select arrow 17. You see that arrowheads are added at the beginning and end of the open path. This time, I will show you how to change the size of the arrowhead without changing the thickness of the line. In the stroke panel, click the Link Start and End Arrowhead Scales icon and type 300% for scale. You see that the size of the arrowhead increases. In the stroke panel, click the Swap Start and End Arrowheads icon to swap the position of the arrowhead. In the stroke panel, click the Extend Arrow Tip Beyond End of Path icon to see that the arrowheads inside the line moves to the end of the line. This time, I will show you how to change the length of the line without changing the size of the arrowhead. Select the Direct Selection tool from the Tools panel and select only the end anchor point of the path. While holding down Shift, press the left or right arrows several times on the keyboard to make the length of the line shorter or longer. Hold down Shift and press the up, down, left, and right arrows on the keyboard when you want to move objects quickly. After selecting the first line, select Weight 3 point in the stroke panel. Click the Arrowheads drop-down button on the left to select arrow 33, and click the Arrowheads drop-down button on the right to select arrow 21. In the stroke panel, click the Link Start and End Arrowhead Scales icon to disable it. Then type 200% in the left scale to make only the scissors arrowhead larger. In the stroke panel, click the Profile drop-down button and select Width Profile tool. Click Flip Along icon to flip the path shape of the profile back and forth. If you press Ctrl-Y to see outline, you will not see the dashed line and the arrowheads, but you will see the solid line only. Press Ctrl-Y again to return to preview view. As you have just seen, arrowheads can be seen, but they are made in one piece that doesn't exist in the actual line. If you want to separate the arrowhead from the line, go to the Object menu and select Expand Appearance. You see that the shape of the arrowhead changes to a path shape. Right-click and select Ungroup. Select only the expanded line and the circle. Press down Delete to delete them. Now you are available to select the scissor-shaped arrowhead separately. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to release the selection. Press Spacebar and drag the mouse down to move to the fifth page. Press Ctrl-0 to fit the artboard to the window size. If you make a rectangle with a dashed line, the shape of the corner is irregular, which is not good to see. Select the second dashed box to change the shape of the corner. Then, click the alignment dashes to corners and pass ends, adjusting length to fit icon in the stroke panel. You see that the dashed line corner shape of the box changes to fit the shape perfect. So far, you've learned the options and how to use the stroke panel, which is essential for working with strokes. I hope this tutorial has helped you understand the stroke panel. Well, this is the basics of the stroke panel in Illustrator. Thank you for watching Professor Grace's Illustrator lecture. Please watch the next video in order to follow all the courses without skipping a lesson. To keep learning and master Illustrator, please press the subscribe and the like buttons.